All right.
Coming back at you with something original.
You asked for it, and we are not... Well, you didn't ask for anything.
Yeah, because no one watches these videos, because we suck.
Well, we... Smash... I guess I'll just be Captain Falcon.
Because he's the character I like. I guess I'll just be...
Wow. Yeah. Right, let me change my name.
All right.
While I'm doing that, Griffin asked me... Oh, shit. Nope.
Yeah.
What the most angry I've been in a game.
Multiplayer wise.
Yeah.
Actually, and single player wise too. Tell me about that.
I think it. I'm pretty sure it's been GTA 5 that I can think of. Aki Sora. Okay, cool. That's me. Because just people in that game are dick. Like, you'll just be driving around. I guess it's not anything new. But you'll just be, like, driving around and just someone will run up and shoot you to death. You. All right. Well, anyway,
oh dang it!
You fucked.
I got
up.
This. I got this. I got
anyway,
this.
Anyway, so, yeah, people in that game are dicks. I guess people in most games are dicks. What games have I played that made me really mad? I guess I don't know. It's not really a game, but like, my TV used to just shut off every like 13 seconds. Oh, also another thing that made me really mad. I used to play Lego Indiana Jones with Kev, with my brother a lot. Which was, I don't know, it was fun to fuck with the game, because you could, like, park a bus in front of a plane, and then when the plane lands, it, like, launches it into the stratosphere, and you can, like, drive around in space in a bus. Anyway, so, like, we got, like, 99% completion with that game, and then Kev deleted the save file, because he's a dumb piece of shit. So I got pretty mad about that. Okay, well... Let me get reacclimated to this. But yeah, and then like the TV would always turn off, and it was a frustrating time. We had Stanley Steamer show up at one point, and they put a bunch of like little yellow styrofoam things under all your shit. So I just had a bunch of them, and like I would snap them in half every time I got angry. It actually helped for a bit. That shit. No, you bitch. All right, well, that one doesn't count. That obviously.
Just a joke, bro.
So what's the angriest you've gotten playing it?
The angriest I get playing video games, honestly, is I'm a bitch about Super Mario Strikers in the sense of just playing against computers, actually. Which is really funny, because like, I'll be sitting there just like, fuck you, Wario, you piece of shit. Just like, and I get really, really mad, too. But the angriest I get playing online games is NHL. NHL 14, because I'm really good at that, so when I lose, I'm really pissed off. That's the only game I can say I'm like really good at.
I made a lot of people mad by playing like I think it was Advanced Warfare 2. Remember when we went to like Jake's grandparents' house and we like in their
oh
basement?
Modern Warfare 2?
Yeah, and they're like he didn't get a quick scope or just get a kill at all, and I just couldn't do it. I was not very good at that game, but I mean it didn't make me mad because I was like I know I'm bad at this. Yes. You thought?
Continue.
Yeah, Jake and Spencer were getting uber butthurt about that one.
Yeah,
they were like, just shoot him. There was that one time I went to a lock-in with Jake's Boy Scout troop. Which
I thought
you
say with Jake's boyfriend.
Yeah, which was like one of the shittiest experiences of my life. It was like, I can get into it, I don't know. It would take a while, but it was probably literally the worst I've ever felt in my life.
Yeah.
But like at one point, this dude started playing like, because they brought some Xbox and stuff. And they started, and they started playing, like, you know, blobs or whatever, and they're like, dicks, I should have made that, and they're like, hey, Keaton, can play this, and I was like, okay, I was like, I know I'm not good at this, but whatever, get faced,
Oh, but not me do that,
yeah, ow,
but
iframes, no, please,
continue,
So, like, they kicked my dick. This one dude just kicked my dick in at, like, in Nuketown or whatever. And then we went over to, like, Jake's Xbox, which had Halo Reach on it. And I fucking destroyed everyone's anus. Mm-hmm. I was like, fuck yeah. I found out I'm, like, really good at Halo Reach. I like that game a lot. I guess
it is a fun game.
That was, like, the first thing I bought at Best Buy that led me to... That led me to the spiraling rabbit hole of never wanting to shop anything at Best Buy ever again. But then I asked Griffin what his... Oh, this is the play-by-play from 10 minutes ago.
Yeah. Really, well, because we didn't discuss it yet, really.
Yeah.
So
I was asking Griffin what is the most scared he's ever gotten in a game.
So the most scared I've ever gotten in a game, I've played a lot of, like, you know, it's like a bunch of computer, like, horror games that have been really scary.
The Static Speaks My Name.
I've never played that. Is that a real game?
Yep.
Really?
It's free.
Dub, if first I... off.
All right,
well. The most scared was losing that match.
The sun was in my eyes.
City. I was on my phone, but,
I was my phone.
Now, me and Spencer played, I played one game with Spencer, but that was really creepy, because it was just like, you got to a certain point, and then the game was over, but we didn't realize it, so we just kept dying, and it was equally as scary every time, because
these hands, like...
It was equally as three, because these hands just reached up and grabbed you, and, like, killed you.
Mm, wall masters.
It was actually terrifying, because, like, and I should have expected it, too, but Dungeon Nightmares was a really creepy game, but I won't even say that, those might have been the most scary I've ever been, but I used to play with Dominic, and he would use the mouse, and I'd use the keyboard, or we'd switch it up.
Edgy.
So we were like, it was really cool, though, because we were really good at it. And,
because you were jerking him off with one
Yeah, hand. Yeah, I mean, someone had to do it, and it was gonna be me.
It's a dirty
it's
job,
it's gonna be me! But, most scared I've ever been with, like, an actual, like, not, computer, like, flash game. Silent Hill 2 is actually really creepy for me, because, like, the PS2 version that's, like, better than the actual Xbox HD version.
Oh, fuck you. That was in your mouth.
That's better than the actual Xbox version. It's actually, it's really creepy, because, like, I play that game just alone in the dark, like, every single night.
Did you also play alone in the dark?
Yeah, I actually know. But, I play that game completely alone.
Oh, stop.
Completely alone at night, and it was really, really creepy and really, really fun.
Well, that was...
And I always remember, like, when I was done, like, I'd go downstairs and I just felt weird. Like, almost like I wasn't real, which was pretty creepy.
You ain't real.
That kind of freaked me out. I was like, you almost felt, like, sick in a way.
Mm.
But you're just, I felt fine, but I mean, it's just like, you felt really, really weird and just uneasy. And, Silent Hill games.
Deja vu, but I'm so mad. I'm not doing very
well. I was telling Keaton this. I got scared in Minecraft once, because... I just jumped, but I just remember this because, like, it was, like, my first time playing Minecraft, and I walked in a cave, and I was like, yeah, it's dark in here, and I just turned around, there was a skeleton there, and, that just freaked me out really badly, but really Silent Hill 2 has been, like, the best thing, and that's my favorite game of all time, so what's the most scared you've ever been?
So it was also probably my favorite game of all time, which, to your Minecraft thing, I just used to get scared a lot in Minecraft because of the whole Herobrine thing. I was like, I don't believe in that, but then I just, like, I'd see a bunch of trees with the leaves cut off and be like, oh, fuck, I'm so scared. Shit, you're gonna fucking ace me. Just kidding. You thought. Oh, yeah, iframes. But anyway. The most scared I've been in a game, and I think quantifiably the most scared I've been in my life, was in Bioshock Infinite.
Really?
Yeah, so...
Is that game actually creepy?
Well, the main story isn't creepy except for one part. There's, like, without spoiling too much, you basically go in, like, a mental asylum, and, like, there's some cool plot stuff that makes it scarier, but basically, have you seen, like, those dudes from the game that have, like, a big-ass bell on their face, pretty much?
Maybe?
They're called, like, Loud Boys or something weird. There's only one of them, which is also kind of makes it creepier, like a Pyramid Head type thing. But basically, he's just this dude with, like, like a headlight on his face kind of thing.
Yeah.
And then he has, like, two big-ass, like hearing horns coming out of this, like, each of his ears.
Yeah.
So you have to, like, walk around him really quietly, and because if he sees you, he'll just shine light on you, and then just, like, make a lot of noise. And then, like, a bunch of, like, you're in, like, a mental asylum, so a bunch of dudes with, like, decrepit Benjamin Franklin and, like, Thomas Jefferson masks come after
Dub.
You.
Okay, continue.
You are a bitch.
Continue.
Oh, I'm playing with a stick.
Whoa, I'm beating my dick. Sorry, you caught me, but now I'm happy about it too. Amen. But continue with the.
Looks Polynesian.
Continue with Bioshock Infinite.
So you go through the whole thing, and it's like really, it's hard as dicks to get around that guy, because he's just a piece of garbage.
Yeah.
And you get to the top, and there's like a little screen or something. You know, you unlock whatever you're supposed to unlock. I'm gonna play something else. Random. And then you like activate something and it's like, okay, you can leave now. And I was like, there's probably gonna be something when I start turning around and I'm like, there's probably gonna be, and like as soon as I, oh, you are a wee fit printer. As soon as I turn around, he's just like right next to you and just goes like, and like literally I saw that and I just went, ah! like screamed at the top of my lungs and then paused the game and like laid down for 20 minutes. Like that is the only time I've like made a noise of how scared I was. And I was like, I'm totally expecting something here. But like before I could complete the thought of there's probably something scary about to happen, it just like came out of nowhere. Oh, well, that was bad. But then also, hey, how's it going?
Also what?
Oh, sweet.
Aw, oh, come on!
Yo, bitch.
Oh. Also, what were you saying?
Okay, that's his recovery. So, one of the it's got DLC, Burial at Sea Part 1 and Burial at Sea Part 2.
Mm-hmm.
And Burial at Sea Part 1's, like, not really, it's just kind of run-and-mill, whatever. But then Burial at Sea Part 2 is, like, the scariest game I've ever played. Not because it's, like, you know, jump scares or whatever, like a Silent Hill type thing. I know Silent Hill's, like, you know, deeper
it's
than that.
It's not jump scares.
Silent
Hill is just, like, eerie. Yeah. There's never been a jump scare.
But, like,
So wait, so there's jump scares in Bioshock? Then no. Bioshock or there isn't? Okay, so it is.
It's like, it's not like why you would, it's like why you would be scared. It's not like, you know, a game that you would think would be scary. It's like why you would be scared in real life. Because it's like, you're going around, and if you take like one or two hits, you're just dead, and you have almost no weapon. You have like, you have like one sleeping bolt, and then you have to get past three dudes that, like, if they see you, they're like drugged up crazy people, and if they see you, they will just destroy you. So it's like, and there's like barely any save points. So you just stress the fuck out trying to get like from point A to point B without seeing anyone, because you can't kill, like you can kill people,
yeah.
But it's like it's really hard. Like you have to, oh, you have to. That's like the third time today. It's
that's okay.
Pretty bad. What's my recovery? Whoa! I can't wait. How do we come back from that?
I have no idea.
But yeah, it's just like super tense, and I think because I have it on my Xbox. You'd probably, I don't know, Bioshock Infinite is a fucking, like, I had one of those nights the other day where I just, like, I stayed up for, like, an hour because I was just thinking about Bioshock Infinite. Like, that's how good the game is. I was just like, man, this happened, and this happened. Like, oh man, at the beginning, I wasn't expecting this to happen. And then, like, it all tied together, and Ken Levine is my hero. Which I'm really sad that that game studio, like, doesn't exist anymore. It's really shitty. Fucking Irrational got shut down next 2K.
Damn it!
Oh, you did it the wrong way! Damn it! And I'm dead. Whoa! Sweet!
What were we saying? Continue what we were saying.
But yeah, Bioshock Infinite is like, I wasn't expecting it because I hadn't played any of the Bioshock games before. And people were like, oh, it's a good game. And I like had the ending more or less spoiled. But I still played through it and I was like, that was fucking awesome. Like, literally, it's like a fucking deep, like, oh shit, like mindfuck game. And then you think about it and it's like, there are no, like, there's nothing that wasn't explained. Like, you're like, oh, what about this? Okay, wait, no, that is explained. And, like, everything
that
makes sense.
That sounds really cool, and I kind of want to play it now.
Yeah. It was free on Xbox a while ago, so I got it. And I paid, like, $5 for the DLC. So if you ever want to come over and play it, yeah.
Yeah, sounds sweet.
Probably wouldn't make a good, like, video series, because the game's, like, 10 hours long. But, yeah, it's fucking dope.
Speaking of that, I guess pretty much this is just going to be an episode just asking questions I actually really like. Game...
Smashcast.
Game that you've just, like, been so enthralled in, I guess, like, that's, like... been your favorite game and then you just are so like immersed in that's like been one of your favorite some of your favorite games. It can be a list, it doesn't matter.
So Minecraft was probably the first one of those for me. Either Minecraft or TF2. I was really into TF2 and really into Minecraft for a while. And to the point basically I know that I'm like addicted to a game if I have dreams about it where it's like I can't go to sleep because I'm just thinking about like mining blocks. So it happened to me for Minecraft, for TF2, Terraria, I know for sure. I think at the Binding of Isaac it happened for me. I'm not sure if it happened for Halo Reach. I played a lot of Halo Reach. It definitely happened for GTA 5. I played a shitload of that.
I was also meaning.
When
like,
did you get that dub?
What are your favorite
dub?
I was also going to say like along the lines of that too is like games that have like you like think like the greatest game of all time like to you like in sense like storyline.
Bioshock Infinite. Like
okay.
I can't even remember.
Can you
like,
think of like? Do you have like any game other games you like think of that are like? You're like top five favorite games of all time? And like...
Probably like Bioshock Infinite. NASCAR Rumble is somewhere on the list just because I love that game so much. It was like one of the first games I played. And like one... Probably the like first game I played was Sonic Advance DX Director's Cut. And now I hate Sonic with a passion, but that game like defined my childhood.
Really?
I love that game a whole lot. Like I beat the shit out of it. So I think that might have to be up there, even though I resent the Sonic franchise.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, I'm Kez Kirby. We'll get him here so we can play this. I fucking hate Kirby. I hate Kirby and I hate Pikachu. But yeah, so Bioshock Infinite, GTA 5 probably might be up there.
You like San Andreas a lot, don't you?
I like San Andreas a lot, but it wouldn't be...
Be like your top...
Game. I don't think it'd be top 5. It was a lot of fun playing that as a kid, though. You thought... Oh, shit. We're having a shelf fight. I didn't... Victory for God! Mike! Kirby wins!
Ball Ghazi, what were you saying?
Sorry. It's fine. I'm gonna eat you. I'm gonna say someone's name that I shouldn't. Like, it's gonna slip out, and I'm gonna have to cut it. A certain Mitt Romney. Like, I'm gonna accidentally say that at some point in one of these videos, and then have to go,
Continue, well, or just kidding. Are you continuing with the games, though?
So yeah, Bioshock Infinite. TF2 might be up there, because I played that a lot. TF2 and GTA 5 are both, like, kind of maybes. The Binding of Isaac's up there. NASCAR Rumble's up there. So, yeah, it'd be like... Quality content. I'm a pacifist.
Are those your top games, though?
Five?
You can list 40 games if you want to.
I'm trying to think. I had a DS at one point. I feel like I should have played. Oh, I think there were some Game Boy games I played a lot. I think Pokemon Sapphire is definitely up there. What's the matter, scared? Oh, bitch. Nope. I don't know, how do I just float? Oh, okay. It's just up. Cool. Ow. Rude. So yeah, Sapphire's up there. There was like a Mega Man game I played. Actually, on like the Game Boy Color...
Was it Mega Man 2? Mega Man
4? It was like Mega Man ZX or something. Oh, okay. It was like Mega Man X. Not X2. It was like Mega Man Z2 or something. But I played that game a whole lot. I don't know. It probably wouldn't be a favorite, though, because I don't really think about it much.
Yeah.
But yeah, Sapphire is definitely up there. I guess, honestly, like, Mystery Dungeon might also be there somewhere. Like, whatever the Mystery Dungeon.
We have...
So, is this... It's not... Oh, you bitch. I couldn't remember if it was still cooked.
I had no idea what it was, so I was really scared. So those are your favorite games?
I think so, yeah. Wait, you got Silent Hill 2.
Honestly, my favorite games are, I don't know the order of them, honestly, but Silent Hill 2 is number one by far. That's the one I can say is definitely number one, but I loved Ocarina of Time, because I never played that game as a kid. I just played it, like, when I was, like, 13 or... No, that's probably, like, 14. And, like, I was like, this is really great.
Oh, shit.
Silent Hill 3 is one of my favorites. Silent Hill 1's really cool. I really like Mario Kart games. Those are really fun. But Earthbound's definitely one of my favorites. That game is fantastic. Have you played any Earthbound?
No.
It is fantastic.
One of the games I played a lot as a kid, because my dad had it on his, like, work computer at school... at UNCC.
It was porn.
Yep. Well, there was one game that was kind of Mirror's Edge-y that he used to play that looked pretty cool, but I didn't really play that ever. But Earthworm Jim was like a game.
Oh, was that on his computer?
Yeah.
It's really cool.
Yeah, he played Earthworm Jim a lot, and I was like, this game's fucking dope. I remember there's like a 3D section where he's chasing that like chicken guy. It's like, nice. It's like plant. I can't remember what song it is, but it's like, you know, like a song.
Wow, I love that song. Yeah, thanks. Really good one.
Yeah, it's by... Band? Oh, I love Band.
Wow, Band and song, yeah, that's
you love
great.
Band. Probably Ride to Hell Retribution's up there. Five Nights at Freddy's 3. Kirby Adventures in Urethra Land.
Sonic 2.
Yep. Sonic 0911.
We got 20 minutes. Yeah, those games for me, definitely. Like, those, like,
well, you know, it's been nice knowing you.
You know, like, a game's good, but, like, when you beat it, and, like, you just... Hello? You felt like you're, like, emotionally attached to it. I don't know if you've really...
That's how I felt with, like...
Like, I felt that way about, like, Earthbound, Silent Hill 2, Ocarina of Time. Get over here, goddammit!
No, please! Yeah! No, please, no!
No DI!
Get dicked. But, yeah, like I said... Bioshock, damn it. That was the closest so far. Oh, God.
Headphone users, look out.
But yeah, like BioShock Infinite, like after I beat it, I just sat there for like 10 minutes. Like,
and just admired the game.
Yeah, I was like, well,
that's
like,
yeah, that's kind of what I did for Earthbound and Silent Hill 2. And
I was like,
I will say, when I beat Silent Hill 2, though, the one that's my favorite game of all time, and the one thing that pissed me off is the end credits. Have I showed you the song from the end credits?
No.
Because everything is it
Only Time by Enya?
No, it's called Angels Thanatos, and it's the fucking worst, like, butt rock song I've ever heard in my entire life. Because, like, all of a sudden you're just like, if you listen to the soundtrack, like, nice. Wow, look, all this is so, like, great and ambient and just really cool, and it's, like, really good noise, and it's just, you feel like you're trapped. And then, like, at the very end credits, da na 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 da na 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 da na 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 I just, like, I remember skipping shit.
Oh my! Back in the game.
I would rather listen to Dead Rising shit, honestly, but God, yeah, that just fucking pissed me off like a lot. All right, this Shout is the final match.
I like how my name was in there, by the way. That's kind of suspicious.
What?
Oh god,
what
name was in there? What? Mr. Game & Watch. Yo boy. Oh, that was an 8.
Oh fuck you, Dr. Mario.
Someone was telling me they played as Dr. Mario, and I was like, oh, damn, that's like 4 today.
All right.
Yeet.
I really want a Game & Watch. That'd be some tight shit.
That would be cool. They'd be like, oh, cool, I can be an octopus, and that's it.
Do you know anything about Xenoblade Chronicles at all?
Nope.
It's, like, it's really cool, because, like, now that I've played, like, 3 seconds of it.
But you, like, need a 3DS, and I have a
Oh, TDS. No, it's on the Wii, too. It was originally for the Wii.
Where's my phone?
All right, we're taking a 3-second break.
KeatonGW just uploaded a video. Cyberbullying's no joke. We're gonna put a pause on this one, folks. Sneak peek into the, So wait, how did Cyberbullying's No Joke upload? How did that upload? What? And you vote in Utah didn't upload. Turn to editing. Let me throw... Alright, custom thumbnail. There we go. I think it's just called yubish. Hey, Mario. I'm not cutting any of this out, by the way.
But yeah, Xenoblade Chronicles, like, the thing that was cool is... In the background, like, you see the dude in the background right there?
Yeah.
It was, like, two gods were, like, fighting, and they just live on, like, these two gods.
He's got a little twin towers on top of his head,
yeah,
too.
He does, but they like, live on these two gods.
Nice.
I think that's what it was. I only played 3 seconds of it, but it's pretty cool.
Way to rip off Terry Pratchett.
Terry Shulk.
Pratchett, if you're listening from hell.
Shulk, if you're listening.
Holla, if you hear me.
That's cool. I think we say if you're listening way too much, but I really don't care.
Yeah, I don't give a shite.
God... Mario is so close, but yet so far.
Crawling in my skin! Yeah, there it is.
These wounds that will not heal!
Let me give that a like.
Oh,
I'll
boy.
I'll have this playing in the background. I won't have the sound on or anything. But I gotta get that YouTube money somehow.
Yeah.
Fun.
Alright, let's boogie.
Anyway, back to this. Ow.
They made a, I wanna say, like... you probably don't care about this, but, like...
I don't.
No, I was going to say, I really like physical copies of games rather than, like, downloads. Copy. Like, as long as, if it's the same price, I'd like to get...
Wait, what? Why is this 27? Ah, damn it!
What happened?
I uploaded the, one of the test videos. This one's 21 seconds long. Whoops! Sorry, folks!
Here's another close-up of Mario.
Well, we're gonna have to figure this one out.
Oh, I guess I killed you right then, so that's pretty cool.
Well, shit, I had all those tags in there. Damn it, I gotta go delete
that. What was I going
that.
On about?
Xenoblade Chronicles.
Was I still talking about it?
I don't know.
I don't think it was. You. I don't
my channel, so I gotta go delete that. Whoops.
Ugh.
Oh, shit. Nah, whatever, it'll keep uploading, hopefully.
But yeah, Xenoblade Chronicles has been pretty cool for the 3 seconds I played it.
Actually, one of the videos finished publishing when I, like, closed my computer. Did you kill me?
No, you had already tapped and I paused
it. Able. Okay, can you please load computer?
Look at this. Computer. Look at this.
Here, let me,
Fuck, fuck, no! Fuck, fuck, no!
You thought? Alright, it loaded. Hold on. One view 3 minutes ago. Yeah, it's 22 seconds long.
Oops! What's the sound check like?
I don't know. But
I think we might have said something really offensive. Oh, no, was that the one for the Raiders thing?
Hopefully.
I think it was. I don't. We don't really say anything that offensive.
And I mean, I don't.
Our sound checks.
I wish I could have just kept all of the sound checks for.
You should just keep that uploaded.
No.
And then put Cyberbullying's No Joke for Real as the actual one.
I meant delete. I don't. Bruh. Please, just load.
While we're waiting, I'm gonna go beat off.
Alright, cool. I'll keep the people entertained. What is in my pocket? So yeah, select actions delete. Cause I'm a rough rider. Well, I gotta go through that whole thing again. Upload. Processing on that U-boat video better finish. Again, a sneakity peekity. Probably should have seen that it was like not very a big file. It'd be Hammer Time 5? Hammer Time 6? Maybe even Hammer Time 7?
Maybe might wanna roll my windows down and close.
Wait, this one being recorded right now? Okay, okay, I gotcha. So this is the right one, I believe. It's 2.6 gigabytes as opposed to 36.8 megabytes.
So I want to point out that someone commented at the Hurricanes Instagram. They commented, because like, you can paint lines on the ice.
Mm-hmm.
And they commented, why don't you use decals? And I just want like the Canes to like comment back, why don't you shut the fuck up?
Why didn't your dad pull out?
It's on ESPN. They're just like, wow. Oh my god. Stefan keeps fucking posting edgy 9/11 posts, and it's actually pissing me off.
Edgy?
Wait for
it. Well, I haven't seen that one from 2002.
I just...
Memes.
Ugh.
We weren't aiming for the truck. Memes.
I'll have you know, my dog died in 9/11.
Yeah. My dog... Yeah. So, for this one...
Oh my god.
I remember that. So check out my description. Joke.
This is the one day I will never make a 9/11 joke on. Like, I just don't. I don't know why. It's just...
Moment of silence. Man, this is just a super technical, like, podcasty thing. Please. No. Jokes. I can't remember what the rest of the shit I put was. Custom thumbnail. Yubish.jpg. My butt kind of hurts.
Your butthole hurts?
No, my butt kind of hurts.
Oh.
My underwear is all bunched up. Where the shit is that picture? Okay, yabish. There we go. Get the fuck out of the way. There you go. Thank you. Choose. Bully. Don't. Cyber. Though, funny edition monkey comedy special. I'm just gonna upload all of this anyway. Monetization.
I'm glad you guys have all been here for this.
Yeah, thanks for sticking around, everybody. Anyway.
Also, I'm pretty sure I'm 3-0.
Publish? No, that's not true at all. All right, let's get back to it.
All right,
let's
ready?
Get down / dirty.
All right.
Wow, those both hit me. Damn it, it was one.
Oh my god! Wow, there I go.
There goes my hero. He's
watch
not ordinary.
It,
I don't like the Foo Fighters, really.
Remember how Jake Selvey, yeah. I feel like with Foo Fighters, it's like you either don't really like them,
or you, like
you
them.
Are... Alright, shut your mouth. Or you are the biggest Foo Fighters fan. Oh! You thought?
Yeah, you're really right, though.
Like, isn't... Oh wait, I can just... Yeah.
Oh!
Octopus!
What were we saying, though?
Isn't, like, Will, like, a big-ass Dave Grohl dick
I think Trent loves Dave Grohl more. I like Dave Grohl, but, like, I'm not a big Foo Fighters
Who
fan.
Who does Will just always jerk
Led Zeppelin?
Off? Gotcha.
Will is obsessed with Led Zeppelin, and I think Spencer was just saying, like, how, like, Will would defend Led Zeppelin about anything. And, like, honestly, I don't even like Led Zeppelin that much. I'm probably gonna get crucified for saying that, but, like, it's, like...
Yeah,
it's
I don't like that whole genre, honestly.
No, like, not really the
I
genre.
I mean, you can...
I
I'm
love
sure,
Pink Floyd.
Yeah.
Like, I really like
I
Pink
like
Floyd.
I like Pink Floyd, too.
Pink Floyd's really cool. But, no, it's just, like... I don't know, Led Zeppelin's just kind of one of those things, like, I can listen to, and it's fine, but it's just, like, I will never just be, like, sitting at home listening to Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
I mean, there was a phase where, like, I went through, and, like, all I listened to was classic rock. I was one of those.
Yeah,
but, like,
you're Alicia Bell,
yeah.
Except instead of that, you listen to Black Veil Brides,
yep.
a.k.a. classic rock.
Of course. But it was just like, the more like I like, as like I got like more and more into music and the more bands I started liking, like, I just like, I just started not really liking like Led Zeppelin that much. Like, I think Pink Floyd like actually puts Led Zeppelin to shame. And I know like a lot of people argue Led Zeppelin, like people don't even think Pink Floyd's slightly as good as fuck.
Yeah, scroll one up for the child Dang hentai. It.
No dub.
Yeet yeet.
But,
Mr. Game Hentai.
But yeah, like,
Mr. I Gay just, Hentai.
Like, people will defend the shit out of Led Zeppelin, but I'm one of those people who, like, if someone were to talk shit about Led Zeppelin, I'd be like, okay.
Don't talk ish about fam.
Don't talk ish about Zepp. John Bonham choked on his own vomit and died.
Same. Should we go one more or something?
Yeah, like, we should.
When should we stop?
We'll get a little more content, because we were more going? Just like,
all right, what's the next question we need to think of?
God.
You're not going rando, you bitch boy?
Oh, I'll go rando.
Last one.
Okay.
I guess random.
All right. But think of a question quick. Think of a question. I'm going to give you 10 seconds.
Fuck, marry, kill, that TV, Taylor's,
fuck you.
Taylor's keychain. And the bottle covered in cum.
Everything I'd fuck. Alright. Okay, but serious question.
What's your favorite Pokemon?
I guess we can do that, sure.
No. Fuck that. Hey, I'm Mario. Shit. Well, this is fun.
Something that just annoys you to death.
Jews. I don't know, there's a lot of... Like, people that try hard, like Alicia Bell, really annoy me. Like, people are just way too into it, like, into life. I can't stand. Like, I was working booth, like, over the summer at some point, and it was a dance, like a, you know, dance moms kind of situation.
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm gonna eat that. Oh, you regained health.
Nope.
And, like, the lady that just walked up into the booth with us and, like, started, like, giving us shit to do, she was just, like, way too into it. She was like, all right. Hey, Keaton, my name's Terry, or, you know, whatever.
Get the fuck out of here, Terry.
Yeah. Hey, there's Golf Island.
Whoa! Whoa!
Oh. Splat, or whatever. Flood, that's what it was. It's not splat.
Dub.
But yeah, she was just, like, way too excited. Like, all right, and then you're going to play this song, and it's going to be, oh, and they're going to have a lot of fun. And it's like, all right, well.
Shut up.
It's like, yeah, you do not need to be this enthusiastic. And it's like, you can tell it's just because she's, like, getting older, so she wants to, like, remain hip with the kids or whatever. And it's just, like, not happening.
So she's basically the worst thing ever?
Yes.
My least favorite kind of person, honestly, like, I guess this is kind of, like, pretty much a lot of people don't like this, but. Just, like, people who care way too much about what people think about them.
Yeah.
That is really annoying, because, like, you, for instance, I think it is hilarious, everything, like, Keaton was wearing cowboy boots today and a shirt that said hashtag single.
An extra, extra small women's, like, V-cut raglan t-shirt that someone sharpied the words hashtag single onto. That I got for 50 cents in the parking lot of a battered woman's shelter.
But just, like, there's so many people that, like, it's just, like,
I, like,
the second...
down, I kind of do care, but it's also, I think, like... I mean, it's also, you know, if I actually cared,
everyone cares ever so slightly, but it's just, like, people are, like, so ridiculous. Just, like, they're, like, oh, well, I mean, like, I'd wear that, but I don't want anybody to judge me. I'm, like, that's,
like,
fucking
stupid.
It's, like,
who fucking cares? Like, when people get nervous about, like, presenting in front of people, it's, like, no one gives a shit.
Yeah.
It's, like, no one, like, sorry, but nobody in this class gives a shit about you. Like, it doesn't...
Yeah, that is actually...
Even if you just fuck it up extraordinarily.
I won't say, like, I hate when people, like, get nervous, because I understand it happens, but just, like, I don't know why people get that nervous.
Yeah.
But, like, I know, Donovan actually gets really nervous presenting in front of people.
Don't talk-ish, fam.
And, like... He just says, like, you know, like, he, like, it pisses him off, because, like, he had, like, some people, like, being, like, assholes to him about that, and I thought it was bullshit. But, like, it's just, like, honestly, like, I'm just one of those people who, like, I don't care what people think of me. Two, if I get up and present something, I'm not gonna care if it's terrible or cringy or anything.
Remember that,
like,
one time you came into my English class last semester and, like, started telling me the class about 9/11? Or you asked them if they wanted to join ISIS?
I said something about towers, too, and I said, book your plane tickets. And... That was just in the middle of your class. Like, your teacher was right there, too. But
Ms. Anderson did not give a dog's fuck.
I was like, might as well. But I remember, like, for instance, like, we, in broadcasting, like, Spencer was like, oh, like, people are complaining about, like, the pledge. I should change that. And, like, me and Trump both were like, no, who gives a shit?
Like, literally, like, as soon as the pledge comes on, Alicia fucking bolts to attention to be like, I pledge allegiance to the... And then, like, literally, no one else even stands or says
everyone
anything.
Is just, like, Zeke like, hot-pilling.
We don't give a fuck. That shit's so dumb. Like, I kind of did it last year, and now it's just, like, I'm not even...
I used to stand, but, no, like, people, I guess, complained about it. Like, Spencer, like, was, like, taking that to heart for whatever reason, kind of. And he was like, oh, I should
fuck
change it.
Like, anyone else said.
Yeah, and, like, I was like, just, like, me and Trent both were like, dude, like, why the hell would you even care? Like, I'm not gonna act like a bitch to someone. Like, if, like, let's say, like, a teacher, like, gets mad at me, like, this is another topic, but, like, if a teacher gets mad at me, I'm gonna be like, oh, I'm so sorry. Like,
yeah.
I'm just gonna say, okay.
I'm gonna say, okay. So, my ultimate, you'll know if I'm, like, truly mad at you. I've only used this, like, once or twice. But my ultimate, like, I am fucking done with everything, code word is cool beans. That I said it to when Miss Candy was like, Keaton, you need to stop being unique. I just said, cool beans, and I walked out of there. And then also remember that time that one substitute wouldn't let me take, or got pissed at me for taking
a shit? Oh my god, Keaton took a shit. And she waited for you.
Yeah,
she
let me set this up. So, we were in American history. This lady's name is, like, Miss Dale. So if you're listening,
it's all over. No,
get
no!
that dub.
No. Oh! Okay, continue.
So I was just like, you know, I was sitting in class. We had a substitute for Mr. Gibbons' class. And I had to take a shit.
Yeah.
And she said something about not going to the bathroom, whatever. But this fucker. Okay, so she's also like a full-time teacher at our school now. I noticed, and she's like right next to Gibbons, so I have to stare her down every day.
Oh my god!
The dub! Anyway.
I'll
just finish the story and then we'll be done.
Okay.
So I'm just like, hey, can I go to the bathroom? She was like,
mm-hmm.
So I was like, well, I had to take a shit, so I'm just gonna go either way. It's not like we had bathroom passes for the class anyway. So I just left and I took a shit. And I came back, I took
a shit.
He
was only gone for like 10 minutes, too.
Yeah, and I came back, and I...
She was waiting at that fucking door!
Deadass, she was pacing in the hallway, and she was just like, where were you? I was like, I was in the bathroom. She's like, well, why'd you take so long? And I said, I was dropping some dookie bombs.
And she was like... shitting my guts. Did you actually say that to
her? I told her I was dropping some mad dookie bombs. Did
you?
And, yeah.
She never told me that!
And she,
how come you never told me that? Where's our connection?
So she just got, like, you know, mad or whatever. She's like, all right, go sit down. So I sit down, and then, like, I go stand up I tried leaving at the end of class, and she's just like, all right, we both know what I said and that you shouldn't have gone to the bathroom. I don't care if you pretend that you didn't hear me or whatever, but we both know. Saying this loud is like an exaggeration. She was like, we both know that that isn't what happened, and if you don't ever do it again, you are disrespecting me. And I dead ass looked at her. I said, cool beans, and I left like halfway through.
No,
halfway through a conversation.
He said, bite it, you scum. Gigi yeah. Allen came out and ate shit.
I
and died.
Shat on myself, and then I said, gluttony, you pig, you whore. And then I said, Zooey mama, and I crashed.